good. How are you?
Not bad.
How are you doing, Mikhail? No, you just like to be tall.
I don't really
mind. You're tall where you go. I know your wife. Your wife always gets good seats, and she should have stood right here. Right?
Yeah.
Don't even.
Is that where you're going?
The guy that was announced in the NBA, he coached Dane his fifth grade year. Dane only played one season, so he played in high school. And because of this guy, and now they stripped him of coaching, but they've given him a microphone. The audacity he has to say, the reason kids stop refereeing is because of the parents. I'm like, number one, there's not a kid ref out there right now, or nobody would be involved, right? And the second thing is, Jim, it's not been that long ago. My memory's not that bad, and I remember you going halfway across the field after him, and his wife had to run after him. So I'm like, you know, maybe you should say that with public service stuff, but for somebody else, I stopped short of. Jen's like, don't go tell him. I'm like, okay. I'm like, you're right. I gotta be the bigger guy. Walk away.
You know, I'm still.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. And the next day, feel totally different. But in the moment, we get so worked up with the blood down, like the blood pressure goes up. It's not good for me, you know. But it's a competition. It's, you know, it's a competitive thing. And, that's where you got to remember it's okay to be competitive for a certain time, and then, you know, it's okay for yourself. Somebody's got to go here.
Sit by me.
I'm going to go on there.
I have candelabras for you.
Send you over referral thing because then you get your money if you go for the referral.
Thank you.
was he out?
When he was out 2 weeks.
Okay.
He missed 4 games. And then all his
game. I bet.
He's quite a player. I'm sure they miss him. And he can't be out.
Yeah, he's, so, you know, he played a lot last night. Because I think, you know, coach is now like, all right. Because he said, because I'm clear. So they were trying to work him back in.
Yeah.
First game, he had 2 touchdowns in the shot. We're all like, oh.
Thank you.
What?
I'm Patrick.
Hi there, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Did you bring me another mask? Did you bring another one?
Sitting in for Craig Swat tonight.
is going to be doing a great job, so welcome him as well. And we're going to kick this off. It's going to be a great concert. So let's begin with prayer in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, thank you for all the gifts in our lives. Most especially, thank you for the gifts of these students, your sons and daughters, students of Catholic Central who come to sing every day, and for what they bring to us and what they give to us through their music, through their expressive nature. We ask that you bless this concert, help them in all that they've done, help their minds to be sharp and their voices to sing well. We pray for all those who are struggling in any way within our Catholic Central community and particularly within our choir community. Comfort them, be with them, help them to know your presence. And finally, we just ask your spirit to be upon all of us tonight, a spirit of gratitude, but also a spirit of love for one another. And in that spirit, we'll call upon Mary, our patroness, as we pray together. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Great. So I'm going to welcome our men's choir to come up. We're going to take just a minute to... singing for the entire class period. We'll do some singing, and then we've been watching, kind of surveying a bunch of like musical theater shows this year, which has been really cool. So you'll hear a lot of that tonight as well. But we're gonna kick it off here with just a fun song. This is The Lion Sleeps Tonight. Yep, it's that one. The one from the radio. Yep, exactly. You're gonna love it, fun. So let's welcome the men's choir.
We don't want more. Thank you.
And I really want to wish Sydney Walsh a very happy birthday today.
Thank you.
there's probably a lot of families, this is your first concert as well. So hopefully you're loving this. I hope that you are. It's been great. We're gonna have the women from the Chicago Choir come out now. And we're gonna put a song together. This is actually a song that we were working on last year before we all didn't have school anymore. And this is called the Sarah Varela song, and it's called She Used to Be Mine. It's from the musical Waitress, and it's just a great musical to start with. But this is a great song as well. And, so we're having one of our seniors, Eleanor Livingston, will be singing the solo on this. Here we go.
Broken and bold as well. She is messy, but she's
also for, since it's your first concert, one of the challenges that we've had, there's my venue, but is that we don't normally perform in the gym. We're normally in the cathedral. And so we have that down pretty well. This is a new space for us, kind of for a spring concert for sure. It's kind of getting used to all of it, but it's good. And so it's part of that is we're gonna try a different setup here for the consult choir for this song. And this is a beautiful song. It's called Do Not Be Afraid. It's by Philip Stopford. And I'd like to put a little cuts to it. As you know, with everything that's gone on in the past year, there's been a lot of fear in the world. There's a lot of people who have suffered and are suffering. And so we want to hold off, we want to kind of dedicate this song to all of them. This is a song about hope and about trusting in the Lord. In a special way, though, COVID has been throughout the world, but in our own community, we've had families who have suffered because of coronavirus. But we've also had in our choir families, Mr. Gilbert, who passed away, and so he's living here. And so we want to lift up the Gilbert family during this time. And then right now, we have Mrs. Whitlock is hoping to get a lung transplant, and so we want to lift up the Whitlock family. During this. So, and these are families that I know of, and their children are in these choirs, but you probably know people as well. So let's lift all those families up as we sing this song called Do Not Be Afraid. one of the things that's really essential, I think, is kind of recognizing the dedication and the hard work that students have done. This year, we haven't done a lot, but there's been a lot of hard work, because what we've done has been hard. But there are people who have served with us with the Madrigal Dinner, and with concerts and tours, masses that we normally sing at weekly. So these kids normally, in a normal year, are working a lot, and singing a lot, and it's great. And so we want to take a moment now to recognize our juniors and our seniors. These are people that have been in choir for 3 years for the juniors. So these are juniors who have been in choir for 3 years. And sometimes it takes until your senior year to get those 3 years. But once you do, though, we honor them with an academic letter. So I'm going to call these people to come forward. And then, juniors, you can all stay here. When you come up here, I call you, just come up here and make a line. Come right up here on the risers, okay? And then we'll give you your letter. And then we'll have all the juniors here, and then we'll have a sit down, and then we'll do the same thing with the seniors, all right? So, for our juniors who have been in choir for 3 years and getting an academic letter tonight, we want to congratulate Liam Durkin. Charlie Kehoe. And then to invite up. Yeah, so if you're a senior, you might want to start making your way down it so there's not that big ballroom descent for the risers there. All right. So we want to start with, there's a story about this for the seniors. And this is one of the things that, again, was so hard last year not doing this. Some of these seniors will be getting letters because this is perhaps for a year they didn't take off choir, maybe they joined their sophomore year. So some seniors will be getting letters, which is true. But all seniors, though, will be getting two things. The first of which is a rose, which is to symbolize the beauty of what we do, the beauty of music, the beauty of art. But that rose is going to fade, and it's not going to, it is beautiful, but it's like music, after a certain time it kind of evaporates into the air, and roses decay. But then I also give them a cross, because that, our faith, never decays, never goes away, if we live into it. And so that's the hope, that this little cross, made by people in El Salvador. I love this too. These are people who are in villages in El Salvador, and they hand paint these, and it's just beautiful. So this is something I hope seniors that you'll take with you, and you'll put in your dorm rooms, and you'll just have them, because it's just a real good way to remember this place and what you did here. All right. So so please welcome the class of 2021 seniors here. We're going to start here with Alondra Cervantes.
Let me do Norio.
finally, but certainly not last year, Abby Whitlock.
Them
and they're always kind of leading by example, so helpful with various things. This is going all the way through high school, right, the whole time. So this is Conductor's Award, and there's gonna be three of these. So I wanna, so the first one goes to Dianara. And then we're gonna do a lot.
Zoom. We'll have the link for you on all of that. Okay? There's a great reception planned outside. So I think as you go outside here, there is like a table. Yep. And so if you'd like to go and just kind of go outside there and just enjoy being together and congratulating these kids, that'd be wonderful. We are also doing a meal sign up for the Whitlock family. So if choir families could, you say you're some of the most generous people I know. If you could, if you've not heard about this and would like to help out, there's a sign up for that as well. So, you know, if everybody made one meal, that would help out tremendously going forward. So consider that, all right? Okay, thank you so much. You've been so wonderful. It's good to be with you. We're just saying the Lord bless you and keep you.
Thank you.